You know, I haven't spoken on the ongoing genocide in Palestine yet, for the same reason I suspect many creators who haven't spoken on it yet have neglected to speak on it. Cowardice. But genocide is bad, and what the Israeli state is doing to the Palestinian people with the support of the US government is genocide. It's pretty simple. The worst thing that can happen to me is I lose my platform and I have to go back to work at Jimmy John's or something. And that was probably always going to happen at some point anyway. It doesn't really compare to what's going on there and being complicit in silence, does it? And I do believe that our government is scared of our ability to organize and speak out about it on TikTok specifically. And it's a big part of why they're so keen on shutting it down. I mean, Mitt Romney spilled the beans and said the quiet part out loud recently. He said some wonder why there was such overwhelming support for us to shut down potentially TikTok or other entities of that nature. If you look at the postings on TikTok and the number of mentions of Palestinians relative to other social media sites, it's overwhelming, so among TikTok broadcasts. How fucking un-American is that? And that's a rhetorical question. It's absolutely un-American for the government to censor us because they don't like what we're saying. If what we're saying is shitty, we can face all the social consequences available without the government infringing on our right to say it. On the other side of the aisle, Joe Biden and Hillary Clinton have doubled and tripled down on the belittling and patronizing idea that nobody talking about what's going on over there understands nothing about it. But here's a weird idea, albeit foundational to our democracy. Politicians should listen to, take seriously, and make policy around how their constituents feel. Me, I don't want to pay for a genocide and I don't want to be complicit in one either. It's still pretty simple.